acne. Now, acne, you guys all know, is a clinical diagnosis. Basically, someone comes in, they complain of acne. There's no diagnosis other than just looking at it. Where if it's a whitehead, it's called a closed comedone. If it's a blackhead, it's an open comedone. So acne vulgaris, pilosebaceous issue, and multifactorial between stress, food we eat, sometimes hormones. Now, any combination of the open or closed, they can have inflammatory papules, raised bumps, pustules filled with pus, nodules, and cysts. It is a clinical diagnosis, as we mentioned. So if you are a clinician and someone comes to you with acne, or it's a family member, what are some things we can do? Benzoyl peroxide is a first-line treatment for mild to moderate. The retinoids, now as we're getting into the retinoids, it becomes, some primary care PAs do that, but for the most part, we're possibly talking to dermatology. Now the antibiotics, erythromycin or clindamycin, please remember guys, it's antibiotics too, but there's an anti-inflammatory effect. So it's kind of like a twofold. If I said to you, just a quick question for you. If I said to you erythromycin, what's the spectrum on that? Does that kill gram positives? Does it kill gram negatives? Does it kill atypicals? As practicing PAs, when should erythromycin be our go-to? Well, acne, but please remember, erythromycin was our first macrolide. It is very good for gram positives and atypicals, okay? So if they asked you, what is a antibiotic of choice for a strep throat who had an anaphylactic reaction to a penicillin, erythromycin would be fantastic. Very good for gram positives, horrible for negatives. Clindamycin. Now, clindamycin is very good for gram positives and anaerobes. Okay, so if I said to you anaerobic coverage like aspiration pneumonia, we would be thinking clindamycin or metronidazole. Most people use metronidazole. Please remember, clindamycin is the highest risk antibiotic to cause C. diff, and there's been lawsuits from that. Now, as it gets, you know, more moderate and severe, the antibiotics and people are on typically prophylactically. Hormones can be an option. Try to regulate hormone flux. Now, the systemic retinoids like Accutane, this is only prescribed by dermatology. It is a dangerous medicine. But when I worked with dermatology PAs coming through our courses in the past, it is impressive to see dermatology providers kind of say, this is a miracle medicine. You can have someone who has very, very almost disfiguring acne, and you catch them 3 months later and they look stunningly cleared up. Now, it's teratogenic, hepatotoxic, and there's a risk of depression and suicide. So Accutane, a very, very powerful medicine. Colleagues, if you have a patient who's really struggling from acne and it's really, you know, you're in your influential years, your real developmental years, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, refer them to dermatology. Now, what they will do is the teratogenic nature is so bad, they insist on two forms of birth control, and one of them's got to be an injectable, okay? And they typically have people go through a psychiatric assessment because suicide goes up. So that's something we got to be, it's a powerful medicine, but there's powerful side effects.